Good evening, I'm Nicholas Hoare for PBS. Along with my canine companion, Austin, we are here to talk to you about a very interesting book that has just arrived and which is absolutely superb. When one thinks of London, one thinks of streets, celebrated streets, but which are they? Piccadilly? Perhaps. Regent Street? Certainly. Oxford Street also. But there's one other street which is just as celebrated, but in another direction altogether. Knightsbridge is famous for an anchor street called Sloane. Sloane Street, Sloane Avenue, Sloane Square, Hans Crescent. All these names have one gentleman in common by the name of Hans Sloane, a remarkable physician to the wealthy, who practiced his profession in the 17th century, moved to England from Northern Ireland, and made good big time. He not only developed his own fortune, but he married an extremely wealthy heiress whose money was made from slavery in Jamaican sugar plantations. So together, these two people decided that they would use their wealth to amass what subsequently amounted to the largest collection in private hands of all sorts of collectibles dotted around the world. This man was the first man to put out finders all over the world who would seek out valuables and send them to England. During the course of his career, he managed to amass sufficient that he endowed what is now the British Museum. The British Museum opened up its doors for the first time in 1759, and this man almost single-handedly gave them what it needed to start. The book that I'm talking about is called Collecting the World, Hans Sloane and the Origins of the British Museum. And before you rush for the exits and say to yourselves, oh, it's a museum, just think for a moment. The British Museum may be a little fusty and dowdy, but it is immensely enriched by this colossal gift that was given them by way of endowment by Hans Sloane. The book itself is by a gentleman called James Delbourgo. It is published improbably by the Harvard University Press, and it is one of the most delightful of its type that has come out for a long time. There's a lot of meat to these bones. And if you wish to read a study of what drives the collector, and please don't look around, I'm the worst offender, have a look at this book because I think you'll enjoy it immensely. Collecting the World, James Delbourgo, and on that highly collectible note, good evening.